Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi and welcome back to my channel Fun with Data Science. So from today onwards, what we are going to do is that we are going to do data analysis. So data analysis is a part of a data science, okay? So what we are going to do is that we are going to take a data from any of the websites and then we are going to perform some data analysis, some mathematics, some exploratory data analysis and all that things. So it's going to be very, very, very much interesting. So it can be interesting if you pay proper attention and if you do the things with me only, okay? So now let me tell you, for today, we will be going to have a data, which is data for Google Apps rating. So we have Google Apps and we have a data for Google Apps rating. So we will be performing some operations and the things we will see today. Okay, so now let me introduce that this is a Google collab and in which I'm going to tell you about the Google Apps rating data analysis. So we are going to perform our analysis in this particular Google collab only. So now let's see the features. And okay, so from here you can rename the notebook. I'm renaming, like, you can see, let me rename it as Google data set. Okay, let me name my notebook as this. And now in Google Collab, what we need to do is that here we need to click on file, and after clicking on file, from here we need to upload the data. So I have already uploaded the data, that is Google Play Store.csv, right? So now let's start writing our code and let me see, can I zoom my screen a little bit? Okay, so yeah, I hope now it must be more clearer to you, all right? Okay. So now let's start and let me see. Okay, it's better. So now let's first import the libraries, whatever are the libraries which we are going to use. So we'll be using four libraries in this data analysis. The first one is NumPy. For that, what I'm going to do is that for importing, I write import NumPy as np. So basically this np is a short form that we import the NumPy as np. So whenever we are going to use NumPy, we will simply not write whole NumPy, we are going to use np, okay? And then we are going to import pandas, and we are going to do the same thing for pandas also. So for that, I'm going to write import pandas as and then pd. So basically pandas is imported as pd and I have imported numpy as np, right? Then the third library which we are going to have, so basically these two libraries are used for the mathematics things and all that things, data analysis. Now the third and the fourth library which I'm going to import here, they are used for exploratory data analysis. They help us in giving the bar graphs, pie charts and all that things. So the fourth library for that is, and I'm writing import seaborn as SNS. So basically seaborn is a library which is used for the exploratory data analysis. So for that, what I wrote is that import seaborn, and seaborn is the name of the library, and I wrote the short form as SNS, right? And the last library what I'm going to use is that I'm going to use import matplotlib dot iplot as plt. So basically now the next one which I'm going to use is matplotlib.pyplot, and I have used a short form it for this as plt. Now let me once tell you that firstly what we are going to do is that we are going to import all the libraries. So the libraries which we'll be using are numpy, pandas, seaborn and matplotlib.pyplot, right? Now after that, if you want to run something on Google Colab, so what we do is that we simply press shift plus enter. So when I'm going to do that, it's like running the cell. Okay, so it has run and has not shown me any error. So it means that these all the libraries are imported, right? Now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to import my data. So for that, we need to write something like, you can say we need to write a variable, okay? So let me make that variable as, okay, so let's write Google data. Okay, so I have written Google data is equal to pd.read.csv and in bracket, I'm going to write my data name. So the name of my data was Google Play Store.csv, right? So in the brackets, I'm going to write Google Play Store. dot CSV. Now, just let me explain to that what I have done here is that simply whenever I will be accessing my data, okay, the data which is Google Play Store, whenever I would be accessing that data, I would be using this Google data name to access my data. So now here I will not be using this Google Play Store whole. Simply what I will write Google data, and after that whatever function I want to perform, I will write that, right? So here DF is written. So DF is the most used word, you can say, when we are describing our data, okay? So simply I have written, okay, so now just hold on, let me make it DF only. So basically DF is small in writing also, and yeah, it is the most used word, okay? So what I'm done is there, I made a word that is DF, and now this will store my whole data and it will represent my data, okay? So whenever I want to access my data, when I want to perform any operation on my data, I'm gonna use DF, right? Now what I have done here is that this PD. This PD was a short form for the pandas library, right? So what I'm going to do here is that I'm using my CSV file. That is pdf.read. It is saying to read the CSV file using pandas. And the name of my CSV file was Google Play Store.csv. So in the brackets, I use the semicolons and I simply write the name of my file, that is Google Play Store.csv, right? Now I need to run this. Okay, so it run. Now what I want to see is that I'm going to see that what is the type for my data, what data whatever I have. So for that, what I'm going to do use is a type function. So simply I wrote type, and in brackets I'm going to use this data frame df, the whatever name I have written. Okay, so I'm going to use this, and when I'm going to run it, simply I got the answer that pandas.code.frame.dataframe, right? So it means that we have read and used our data from the pandas. So I hope this line must be clear to you. Now moving towards the next. Now if I want to see my data, that what are the values that are present in my data, what are the columns, what are the rows, for that what we use is that we use a term that is known as head. So let me write it df got head, and we simply put these braces. So what this head does is that it helps us in showing the top five rows of our data. So whenever you simply write df.head, it helps you to show the top five rows of your data. Now when I'm going to run it, simply it is going to give me the top five rows of my data. So like my data contains apps, category, rating, review, size, install, type, price, content, many more things. So basically what it gave me as, it gave me as the top five rows. So the index is starting from the value of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it is going for till 4. So it gave me the top five rows. Now in the bracket, if I write something like 2, and now I run it, so what it is going to give me, it is going to give me the two rows of my data set. So simply, if you don't write any number inside this, so what it is going to give you, it is automatically going to give you the top five rows. Let me remove this 5 from here. Okay, so it is automatically going to give you the top 5 rows. But if you are going to write any number inside this, okay, so you want like this much rows from the starting, so you are going to add, you are going to write that number inside these brackets. Okay, so this was the thing that when we want to start and see our data from the starting. What say if we want to see our data from the end side? So for seeing our data from the end side, what I need to write is that df dot till. So in the upper side we were using head to see the top five rows, and for seeing the last five rows, what we use df dot tail. Okay, so whenever I'm going to run it, it is going to give me the last five rows. So see, my data is having 108 10840 rows. So basically total rows, right? So now basically it is going to give me the last five rows, and after that if you are going to mention any number here, so it is going to give you that much of the rows from the last. Okay, so I hope I made head and tail, these two things, clear to you, right? Okay, so now let's move further. And now simply what I'm going to do is that I'm going to check the rows and columns, that how many rows and how many columns are present in my data set. So for that, what I need to use is that I need to use df. Df is a data frame, and now I'm going to use a new function that is shape. Okay, so I simply need to write df dot shape, and when I'm gonna I need to put the brackets. Okay, now let me run it. And yeah, so see here, what I got the output is that you have 10841 rows and 13 columns. So it is of a format of rows comma columns. So whenever I want to see that what are the what are the total number of rows and total number of columns present in my data, so I simply write df dot shape. This shape is used to tell me the total number of rows and columns in my data, right? So the data which we are dealing with, it has 10841 rows and 13 columns, right? So this was the way for seeing that how many rows and columns are there in our data. Now let's move towards the next, and now let me introduce to a new function that is describe, and I simply need to put this, and now let me run it. Okay, I'll see the output. When I wrote df.describe, so whatever will be my numerical column, so here the numerical column is rating, right? So it is going to give me the statistical things of this, like it is going to give me the count, mean, standard deviation, minimum, 25%, 50%, 75%, and max. So it is going to give me these, these statistical information. So whenever I'm going to use df.describe, it is going to give me the output something like this. These are the things, okay? Now the next thing that comes here is we are going to use the libraries which we have imported. So now I want to see the box plot of my data whatever I have used. So simply what I'm going to write df dot box plot, and after that I'm going to put the bracket. So what it is going to give me, see, just let it run. Okay, so see what I got the output as. So here my numerical column was rating, right? So it simply gave me rating, and then it gave me these points. Now the normal rating is something about 4.5 given here, like this line which is present in the middle. I don't know whether you all are able to see or not, but when you are going to write the code, you will see that there is a line, green color line, which is present between this rectangle. Okay, so this line, green line, is the average. You can say this is the average ratings whatever are the given to the apps. So this was a box plot, but what we are seeing is that we are seeing the circle at the above of 17.5. So what does the circle denote? The circle basically tells us that there are some outliers presented in our data set. Now what are outliers? Outliers are the unwanted data. Understood? They are the, like you can say, they are the values which do not match our data. They are the unwanted values. Okay. So it is something like in our this data we have a outlier. Okay. So now we have to deal with that also. So this was the box plot, and we make the box plot simply. There's a very simple concept for df.boxplot, right? And then braces. So when you are going to do this, simply you are going to get this box plot, and you can easily see that are there any outliers which are present in your in your data or not. So we have some outliers in our data. Further, you will see how to clear that outliers also. Now I had told you about a box plot. Now let's make one histogram also. So for that, what I need to use is that I need to use df.hist. So hist is for the histogram. And now when I'm going to run this histogram, simply it is going to, and let me go it here. And yeah, simply it is going to give me the ratings. These are the ratings from 0, it is going till 7000. And yeah, these are the things. Okay. So it is a histogram, and okay, so okay, fine. So these were the things. And now one more thing, this something is coming at the upside of our all of the graphs. It is array, and then matplotlib.x and something. So if you want to remove that, what you need to do is simply put this semicolon. So when you are going to put this, this must be removed. Okay, so this is the way. And what is this histogram showing, we'll be discussing in a little while, right? So I had told you how to make a box plot and how to make a histogram. Now, here comes one thing that we are going to see in today's video. The main thing that we are going to see, that is data cleaning, that how to clean our data, right? So for that, what I'm going to do is that when I'm going to click on the cell, simply I'm getting two options, code or text. So simply I'm going to add a text here, and now I'm going to give a heading here, right? So simply what I need to do is that I need to put a hash sign here, and I need to write here data cleaning. Okay, so why is this is coming, right? Okay, so this is like you can see it is a form of heading, like we give headings like this in Google Colab, right? Now for data cleaning, what we need to do is that firstly we need to find out all of the information, that what are the information, what are the like columns of our data set, right? So for that, what I'm going to use is I'm going to use my data frame name, that is df, and simply I'm going to write df.info. So info is a function which is used to take the whole information of our data set, that what are the things that are present here. So here what I got is that I simply got these 13 columns, and the column names are also written like app, category, rating, review, size, installs, type, price, content rating, journals, last updated, current version, Android version. So these are all the things, and yeah, these are all the columns which are present in our data set. Okay, now these are the non-null count. Now what is non-null count? That means that how much null values are, like non-null values are present in our data set. We'll be dealing with all the things later on. Okay, and yeah, this is the data type, that what type of data is present, like app is an object, category object, rating is present in float. Only the rating is the term that is present in float value. So that is why we were getting the box plot and histogram of the ratings column, because as I told that histogram and box plot, they will take the numerical values column. So in our whole data, there only the rating is the column which has numerical values, so it is taking that only, right? So this is how we check the information about our data, that like this, these are the things which are present in our data. What is the data type for the columns which are present, like objects, float, and all that things, right? So this is how we do. And now next, what I'm going to check, that how many null values. Null values means that how many are the rows which are empty. So basically what are empty, and there, wherever we have the null values, there's something written as NaN values. Okay. So let me just write df dot, and I'm simply using is null bracket. Okay. So this is the function which is used to calculate. Okay, so just let me go a little down or tilted upside. So this is null is a function which is used to show us that, okay, these are the columns or rows in which you have null values. But here we are not able to see any of the null values, because simply what I have done is that I have used this df.isNull, and it is giving me false everywhere. So I'm not able to see anything true here somewhere. So for that, what I need to use is that I need to write df dot is null, and after that I need to do also apply the sum function. So what it will do, it will calculate me the total number of null values which are presented in a single column. So what it will do, it will just show me all the columns, and in all the, at the front of all the columns, it will tell me, okay, so these are the total some values, that these are the total number of values that are total number of null values that are present in your data set. So when I'm going to run this, simply see what I got here is that, like, see here in the app I got that, okay, you have no null value, right? In the category also you have no null value, but in the ratings you have 1474 null values, that is nothing is present, NaN is written there, right? In reviews, I have no null value, in size and installs, but in type, I have a single one null value. Then in price, I don't have. In content rating, I have one. Genus last updated, I don't have in these two, but in current version and Android version, I have some null values. But the highest null values are present in our rating option, right? So like in our rating column, we have the highest number of null values. Okay, I mean highest number of blank values, right? And okay, so fine, this was about the data cleaning. So like, it's not the whole process of data cleaning, it is how we start cleaning our data. Firstly, we check whole information, then we need to check what are the columns columns or rows, or you can say any block which is null in our data set. Now what in the box plot we have seen that we have some data. Okay, so in this box plot I have seen that I have some outliers in my data, right? So how to deal with that outliers, how to check that how many ratings are outliers. So outliers means how many ratings are greater than 5, because we never have a rating greater than 5, right? But there are some outliers in our data, so we need to check about that. So like, for dealing with them, how do we do? First, let me add a text here and let me write the things which we are going to do, and let me put a hash sign, and then I simply write checking how many outliers are there, right? So like, this was my heading, and after that, now I, as I told you, that outliers must be the values which are greater than 5, because we don't have the ratings greater than 5 in our apps, right? So for that, what I'm going to do is that simply I'm going to use my data frame, that is df, and in bracket I'm going to write df dot, then I'm going to give the name data, and what was the name of my app? Data, and it was, I guess, rating, right? So I'm going to write df dot rating. And let me check whether it is rating or ratings. So it simply, okay, no S is added. So I will write df my data frame brackets, and I will again write my data frame and simply dot, and then I'm going to write that name, that is rating. Okay. Okay. And now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to put a greater than sign and 5. So it will give me all the outputs which are, it will give me that row which has a greater number of greater number of rating than 5. So when I'm going to run it, simply see it, what it gave me is that it gave me a single row. Okay, so this row, that is 10472, it has non rating, it has no rating in our this thing. Okay, so here it is saying that rating is 19.0. The content rating is none. It means that is null value, right? But my rating is 19.0. But my rating cannot exceed 5. So here what we were trying to find, that what are the ratings that are greater than 5. So greater than 5, the ratings that would be greater than 5, they will be treated as the outliers of our data set. So I got one single row, right? That is 19.0. So one of the apps is having a rating of 19.0, and yes, that is, you can say that is the outlier of our data set. Now how to deal with this outlier and how to solve the further processes, we will be seeing all these things in the next video. So I hope you got all the points today, whatever we have discussed. Let me revise this once. That firstly, what we have done, we have imported the 4 libraries. They are named as NumPy, Panda, Seaborn, and Matplotlet .pyplot. So these 4 were the libraries which we have imported, and we'll be seeing the use of each and every library in the further videos. After that, I have used my data. So for using that, I have written df is equal to pd.read.csv. So I have used my Panda library to read my CSV data, and the name of my data was Google Play Store.csv. After that, I checked the type of my data frame. Then I simply wrote df.head. So head was used to find that it was used to show the top 5 rows of our data set. That what are the top 5 rows of our data set? If we are going to write df.head, it will show me the top 5 rows of my data set. But if in the bracket like df.head, you simply wrote 10 or 12 or 15, so it is going to show you 15 rows. So whatever is the number you are going to write in the braces, in the bracket, so it is going to show you that number of rows. But if you are not going to write any of the number, it will simply print your top 5 rows. Okay, so this was about the head. Then after that, I told about tail, and it is used to print the last 5 rows of our data set. So yeah, that I explained. Now this, we have used a shape like a df dot shape. So shape is used to like tell the total number of rows and columns in our data set. So the rows were 10841 and columns was 30. So it is of a form like the first would be written rows and then the columns would be written. Okay, right. Then what I used a function that is describe. So it is used to describe our data. Okay, then I told you about how to make a box plot. And in the box plot, we saw that we have some outliers also in our data set, right? So we will be dealing with them in the further videos. After that, I told how to plot a histogram, right? So we plot that. After that, we moved on to data cleaning. So for data cleaning, firstly, I wanted to check the whole information of my data, that what is the information, like what are the column names and what are the data types and all that things. So for that, I used info. Info is a function which is used to like find whole information about our data. Then I used that isNull, df.isNull. So isNull is used to tell that how many, like you can say, how many rows or columns have null values in your data set. So I was getting nothing, like it was simply showing false everywhere, and neither all the rows were displaying. So what I used is that I used df.isNull.sum. So it just printed me the sum value, that is all of the values that are like you can say all the columns which are having null values, the total number of null values, right? So it just printed me that. After that, we were checking. After that, we tried to find out the row what are the rows that are having the outliers. Outliers means we were having the outlier in the rating column. So what I wrote, I simply do one thing, that I simply wrote df.rating>5. So what it does that it showed me all the rows which have the ratings greater than 5. And yes, you all know that the ratings greater than 5, yeah, they are treated as outliers because we have only till 5 ratings. So we got the outlier here as this 10472. This was the row that was acting as an outlier. Okay. So now in the second part of this video, we'll be seeing that how to delete this row, like how to remove this row from our data set and how to perform the other operations. So I hope you got all the points, whatever I explained today. And I hope you got the idea how to do a little bit of data analysis and how to start data analysis. Okay, so this is all for the video. If you are having any of the doubts, you can either rewatch the video or you can just ask me the doubts in the comment box. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share the channel. So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and bye bye.